Hello, it's Peter Gregg, Miami, Florida. Welcome to the Christmas Room.
Sit back, relax. You are about to watch a Peter Gregg video. Something warm, human, and wonderful happens when you watch Peter Gregg.
Welcome, 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 everybody. This is my final report on the EOS R before I have to ship it back to my buddies at B&H Photo. I want to tell you what I think of it. First, let's do color balancing with the right white. I put it up here, and when I get it in the computer, I click on it with the eyedropper tool, which is in most of the softwares available out, most modern ones these days. I even checked Pinnacle for someone the other day, and yep, there's an eyedropper tool in that one. So they're still available for free while supplies last. Get yours. You're going to pay shipping and handling, but there's no charge for the right white. And yes, I do ship internationally. Goes on the plane and whoosh, it goes. Okay, now one thing I normally do not do is I normally do not use a log format. When I had the Sony recording here, I just used the basic, a neutral type of a profile. Same thing with the Canon. I use a neutral type of a profile. And even on the GH5S and my GH5 and Baby Back Maniac just made a new video, and he actually is using some of the camera. He uses a variety of different cameras, but the GH5 flew over there. Now, I decided to try Canon log here, and I don't know why. Well, yeah, it piqued my interest because I read a report that Canon had put the same version of Canon log in the EOS R like they have in the C200 and the C300 professional level cinema cameras, which are $7,500, $10,000, and so this 4K here is still capable of shooting C-Log. So I figured, let's try it. And you know what? I did a little test, and I'm really, really surprised because the quality that I get, this camera takes a step forward. This is my opinion. Now tell me what you think. I'm wearing the same shirt that I wore when I did the comparison tests with the GH5S. So you've got another video you can go back and look at. But I think this takes this camera and brings it to the level of if you were shooting maybe a C200, that $7,500 camera. And if you were shooting that, but in this size of the crop sensor, that, hey, you get really, really good. Now you can tell because you could see that the shadow areas are much brighter than my normal videos. So what C-Log does, for you guys that don't understand the log files, is just like Canon took this, and it's a full frame sensor, but they cropped it, right? So it's a 1.8 crop, so you're not using the whole sensor, you're just using the little part in the sensor center, which is about the same size as a GH5S camera. So when you're shooting video on an EOS R, it's like shooting Micro Four Thirds, kinda, all right? So what log does is it does the same thing. It is not cropping now. It's condensing. It's condensing the highlights and bringing them down, and it's condensing the shadows and bringing them up. And all you get is this middle part right here. Okay. Now, when you get that into the computer, it's going to look terrible. Here, look. This is what it looks like if right out of the camera with C-Log. See, there's like no color, there's no contrast, there's no highs, there's no lows. So you got to use your skills and bring down the shadows to where they belong. You need to learn to use your scopes, okay? Then you need to bring the highlights to where they belong. And then the face, the area of most importance, needs to be kind of in the middle. So you're going to use all the wheels and all the stuff that you've got available to do that. But it's very easy. And look at the quality. My face looks smoother without me being smoother. Okay. How do I explain that? It's weird. I just look better in C-Log, and it actually takes the camera, in my opinion now, because your opinion might be different. You might have this mental block that, no, it's got crop sensor. I'm not going to like the camera no matter what, and you're going to throw a temper tantrum. And I understand that, okay? But in all reality, by turning on the C-Log, I'm getting a quality level similar to the GH5S, which is a very high quality camera for the price. So the only thing that's negative about the whole thing is that the Canon EOS R is a little high in price, but the quality is better. So let's go over and say hi to Jingles, and you'll see that the focus system doesn't work the best like a dual pixel would normally work. And I think it's because I'm using the 35 millimeter L version 2 on the adapter. I'm hoping it would do better with its own R lens, which I didn't get. B&H didn't send it to me. So, general overview of the camera is I think Canon has a winner, a really big winner. Let's bring Jingles up here because, you know, the fur, his hair is hard to resolve. And I want to see myself. Come here, Jingle Bells. Let me wake you up, baby. I know. I didn't give you any warning. I want to see for myself how it resolves, the C-Log resolves the quality of the dog's hair, because the hair is really hard to, thank you for licking me, I appreciate it, is hard to resolve. Just like forehead shine, cheek shine, chin shine is hard to do on a lot of the cameras. Because of the contrast, because of the, you know, just the dynamic range. But the C-Log is now compressing it, and I hope we're going to get the response in the computer. I haven't seen it yet because I haven't moved this video over there, that I think we're going to get. I think we're going to get really good response. I woke you up, didn't I, baby? So overall view of the camera. The camera is going to be a winner. I called it the camera of the year in one of the videos, which caused a lot of people to go, no. It doesn't have this. It doesn't do this. But in a sales arena, I think people that purchase the EOS R are going to be really darn happy with their camera. You know, what do you think? Yeah, he agrees. Now, you're not going to be buying three or four cameras and comparing them. You're going to buy the one that you like, that you go and you do your research on, and then you're going to pick out the camera that you like. And then from there, you're going to, you know, take it home, and either you're going to be pleased or you're not going to be pleased. So I think the level of people that are going to be pleased once they purchase this camera is going to be high, because it just does everything, well, not everything. It does a lot right. It's got the articulating screen. I could see how I am, move myself to the one side, then move myself to the other side. And I also, I connected up the LCD, which is another unique thing. This camera connects better than any other camera that I have seen to the smartphone. All I do is turn the camera on once it's set up, and the setup was really easy. I turn the camera on, I turn the phone on, I open the Canon app, and it goes searching, and then boom, I get a picture. Nothing else, turning on Wi-Fi, turning off Wi-Fi, and this has been for the entire 2 weeks that I've had this camera. I have never once had to restart, re-kick off Wi-Fi. It just does it from day to day to day to day to day. Today. I was wondering if you got the message. All right. Now, what don't I like about the camera? You would think I would say it's the crop. Okay. I wish it had the bigger crop because I like a deep, defocused area. It makes it look more professional to me as a professional wedding portrait photographer, high school seniors. You try to take dramatic type pictures. So by blurring out the background, you get that. So it does that. Now I'm shooting at 1.8 instead of 1.4, which this lens is capable of doing. The reason for that is if I was going to seriously be interested in purchasing this camera, I think I would go with the native lens, the 35mm 1.8, because, here's the because, if I walk back here and turn around, the focus is not the best. It's not dual pixel focus level. So did Canon reduce their dual pixel focus level quality, or is it because I'm using the adapter? This is a Canon L 35mm 1.4L version 2 on the camera. So it's a $1,600 lens. We're not playing games here. So I put this to 1.8 to see if I still get the one, if I still get the nice depth of field, because we've got the 1.8 crop, and I figured, well, maybe the depth of field is not going to be that good. But that looks pretty darn good. It looks creamy in the background, so it's doing good. So the not having a second card slot would be another negative, that a lot of people would be banging their drums and stuff like that. All right, it's not that big of a deal these days, all right? If you're going to shoot professionally, you might want to not do it. Nikon has a new feature where it actually will allow you to send JPEG images to your phone to use it if you have it in your pocket, in your pants or something, as a second card backup. You know, while you're still recording to the single card that's in the Nikons. So they do have a system. I don't know if Canon will do that. So that would be an interesting thing to look into. The major thing I don't like is they spent a lot of money on this really, really dumb, in my opinion, because I know other people would have other opinions. You know, I'm not the only person on the planet, so it's like there's other opinions that count. But as for me and my house, we do not like this multifunction bar. It's turned off. It causes more havoc. I really want the joystick on there. So I had to remap the buttons on the back of the camera so that the four-way controller down here at the bottom will allow me to move the focus points around on that camera when I'm holding the R in my hands. Okay, because I'm recording with it, so I can't hold it in my hands and record. At the same time, I haven't figured out how to do that. So that the money that they spent in that, they should have put a second card slot. Gee whiz, Batman. Golly gee whiz, Batman. Take off that multi-bar. Put one of the joysticks that you have from the other cameras so you don't have to reinvent the wheel and put a second card slot in there. Why? Well, I would like to have been at that meeting. Can you picture the meeting now? You're at the Canon meeting, and all the big honchos are sitting there and going, okay, let's do something different with this camera. Let's put this multifunction bar on the back. Some people are going to like it, and they're going to go, oh my God, this is the best thing since sliced bread. And those people that don't like it, ah, poo, humbug. I can do that because we're in the Christmas room, okay? 24/7, 365 Christmas room. But anyway, for me, I would prefer get rid of that thing. Put the joystick on there. Too much money was spent on developing that. Put the second card slot. You know, that would have been much more appealing to many, 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 many more people. So other than that, I give this camera, surprisingly, for what it can do, a thumbs up. And now that I'm shooting with the C-Log, and the interesting thing with C-Log is this is supposed to match the C-Log from the C200. So if you have one of these $7,500 cameras, Frank P., I'm talking to you, random Frank P., I know you got the C200 sitting over there in your studio. This is a perfect match. You can shoot log on your C200. You can shoot log on your R. And boom, they match, which is important when you have more than one camera. One, that's one, okay? I'm learning how to work fingers, just stay, okay? But even those of you that have the one camera and you have the EOS R, try the log. It's going to be a little bit overwhelming at the beginning. Yes, I understand that. Okay, when I looked at this in the computer, I go, oh my God, look at this. It's terrible. But then I'm able to make it look beautiful. So tell me what you think. My rating for the EOS R is big thumbs up. I think the owners of that camera are going to love it. I think people that are shopping are going to find reasons to poo it. And I understand that part because, you know, I could go into a nice list of things that I don't like. But, you know, if you put down $2,400, you want to come home with a camera that you're going to love, love, love. All right, that's it. Peter Gregg, Miami, Florida. I'm going to take a picture. So say Christmas tree smile. I will see you in my viewfinder. Whoosh.
You have just watched another Peter Gregg video. Something warm, human, and wonderful happens when you watch Peter Gregg. Thank you for watching. Description of all equipment used in this video plus any notes Peter took while filming are always placed in the description box, show more box, or down arrow thingy next to the title on mobile apps. Duly noted.